What do you do when you're with someone and they're doing something that you don't like? How do you handle that? You know, the nice person thing to do is to not say anything, is to say, oh, I should just get over this, or this shouldn't bother me. Or maybe you try to say, I'm gonna be assertive. I'm gonna tell them like, hey, I don't like what you're doing. You better stop it right now. And you know what? Either one actually doesn't work that well. In fact, just recently I was talking with a participant at one of my live events, and he has a son who's 13, who goes into these rages when he's playing video games. And he was kind of like, I don't like it. He's screaming and throwing. It's kind of scary and freaks me and the dog out. I just want to tell him to stop, and I want to take his Xbox away. And maybe you've experienced this with a, you know, dating and relationship. You know, your partner, your boyfriend, your girlfriend, they do something you don't like, and you're like, hey, just stop that. How well did that go? So what I told him and what I would suggest to you is a much more effective way to approach it is not to suppress it and be all nice, but to approach it perhaps not when it's happening. So I wouldn't suggest he walks into the room and the kid's like throwing the remote and screaming, be like, let's talk about it, son. Just later on, you're having dinner together, he's in a relaxed state, you're having dinner with your partner, or your boyfriend, or your girlfriend, and start with these two magic words. I talk about this in Not Nice. The two magic words are, I noticed. Hey, I noticed that when you play video games, it seems like sometimes you get really upset, like you go into a rage, right? Or if it's a partner or something, like, hey, I noticed sometimes when we're out together, you seem to be really engaged with your phone and not as open to a conversation with me, right? So you're saying, I noticed, and then describing what they're doing, and try to describe it without, like, remove as much of the judgment as you have, as you can, right? So it's not like you go into a rage and you're just a mess. What's wrong with you? Or why are you always in your phone? You're so addicted to that thing. What's your problem? Right? Because if you come in with that energy, what happens? They get defensive, they put their guard up, and no one's connecting around anything. So bring it up, not in the heat of the moment, but later on, and use the two magic words, I noticed, and then just be curious. You know, why are they doing that? What's their experience? What's your partner feeling when she or he is looking in the phone and kind of trying to disconnect? What's this guy's kid feeling when he's playing video games? Is he feeling frustrated? Is he feeling like he's, being beyond the video games, right? Like, who knows what's going on in his life? Maybe he's feeling like this is the only place he can excel because he's not good at anything else in life. And yet when he fails at that, he just feels like totally worthless. I don't know what's gonna come out of the conversation. And neither do you. So just be curious, go into it, and trust that through really being curious and connecting, the other person can start to choose to do differently. And they're not gonna choose to do differently because you told them or you threatened them. So share below about your experience of using this. You know, go test it out, see what happens. What are you learning from this video? I'd love to hear more. And if you wanna know even more how to bring confidence into every area of your life, click below to go to my website where you can download my ebook, 5 Steps to Unleash Your Inner Confidence, for free. I wanna give it to you as a gift. And if you wanna take this to conversation confidence, being more assertive, every area of your life, it's gonna start with those 5 key steps. So get that now if you haven't already. And until we speak again, may you have the courage to be who you are and to know on a deep level that you're awesome.